What's up? This is Christian.
And I'm Steven.
I'm Joey.
And we're in Anberlin, and you are watching LP 33. Our jump to Universal Republic was the best decision our band has ever made, simply because it afforded us so many more opportunities. And we loved Tooth and Nail. Like, they treated us like gold. But we just felt like we were on for new challenges, radio being one of them, and also getting the videos to things like Fuse and MTV. And the last big thing was international. We wanted to start becoming like an international band.
Having this one released like worldwide was a first for us and a huge, huge thing.
We'll start touring Europe, you know, not only Australia, but Japan and Singapore. And I stood in Singapore and just stood and looked at the crowd. And even though there's only 300 people, I'm like, I'm on the other side of the world from Florida. You know, we grew up in a town of 20,000. I remember when Chili's came and I swear there was a parade down the street, you know. Unfortunately, the chasm between us and the fans, the bigger you get, grows wider and wider. We have done our utmost to try to compensate for that with technology, honestly. Like, Christian does the YouTube channel. He does a lot of the videos for Anberlin and, you know, kind of like the behind the scenes thing. Joey, you do the kind of the Twitter and the update for the tour journals on Anberlin.com. And everybody in the band kind of like tries to reach out to the fans so that that chasm doesn't look so great, you know, because I don't want to lose what I view as, in the last, you know, couple years of touring, we have not developed fans, but we've developed friends. A lot of people that we're going to see at the show over and over and over again, you know, that, you know, oh, we're in Detroit, okay, Nicole's going to be here, you know, like, we're in New York, okay, Hillary's going to bleed, you know. And so, like, we've really tried to develop more of friends than fans. We've had some great times, we've had some rough times. I mean, just even in the conception of the band, we would sleep at truck stops, basically underneath the trailer, and slept in basically a crack house with no energy, no heat. It did have gas though, so we turned on the gas stove and we slept our sleeping bags around the stove.
It was minus 10 degrees outside.
Yeah. To Christian missing a Warped Tour date, he just showed up at the precise moment we were walking off stage. Christian just got on.
That's probably my most embarrassing moment in my musical career.
We were more excited about how we could prank him when he showed up, like all of us acting.
Dude, we really gotta talk.
Yeah, like, listen, man, you're out. Me and Christian have a joke called, we just, you know, we're 50 on stage, because, dude, because at 50 years old, you're gonna want to exchange just one day. You know, you're just gonna want this back just one time. And even if it's the worst show, like, yesterday was pretty bad, but at 50 years old, you would give anything to exchange just one day, just have that one show back, and people singing along your songs, jumping up and down. And so even if we're having a rough show, we just yell we're 50, and then kind of just breaks you out of it, like, yeah, I'm just gonna go off as hard as I possibly can, because, man, I would just give anything to just for this one day. You can't walk, you can't get on stage and just go, oh, this sucks, you know.
This sucks.
This is gonna be horrible. You know, you gotta get up there and be like, dude, who am I? I do not deserve this at all.